Here's the thing,
Shane. I'm a little confused. We're in the outhouse, I think, but it feels different. Like, we're not sitting in front of our usual table. Like,
this and we're trying to mix it up a little bit.
Yeah.
Got some drumsticks.
I always feel like...
you got to get comfortable with the mic.
Yeah.
And, you know, I see a lot of people when they're speaking at conferences and stuff like that, and they're not, they're just not comfortable, you know, with the mic, you know.
Yeah,
and it's, I think it takes time. You got to just kind of ease into it, you know, but...
I just feel like I need to channel my inner Phil Donahue, and then I'm fine.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Remember how he did that?
He was great.
He would not give you a heads up at all. Yeah. He would just, where are you from?
Yeah. Or he'd throw out like a random question like, moisture in the Serengeti, your thoughts.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's great. So in the outhouse, man, we just hit our 50th episode. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago, 50th episode.
REM?
Yeah, we featured an REM album, but 50 episodes. Who knew we would last for 5?
I know. Yeah, but I'm digging it. It's fun. You know, we got a lot of people on LinkedIn too. I'm seeing some fun comments on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
You know.
I think it's funny. People don't realize that this is what we always did all the time anyway. Mm-hmm. It's just now we're filming it.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. Props, mics, cameras, you know.
But we'd always just sit around and talk about music we love or talk
music,
about
art,
things we're interested in.
Love, life, you know, all the above and all of it wrapped up in one.
That's it. And like a big burrito. Smoked.
Yeah.
It's like the burrito exquisito.
Oh, what a great. I wonder if that place is still there.
Gosh, I sure hope so.
Willits,
California, Northern California, Burrito Exposito. Didn't they weigh the burrito? Wasn't that a part of it?
Mm-hmm.
Can't remember.
Probably, but I remember the burritos just being like perfectly round.
Yeah.
Like they rolled it, you know?
Yeah.
And had aluminum foil around it.
Did they have a sign in there that said, like, our burritos weigh the same as a newborn baby? I could have swore that.
Yeah. Well,
you get one.
We're also up around like Humboldt County, you know, so there's a lot going on there.
Enough said.
All right, man, what are we doing today?
Well, you know, we've been talking a lot about music. And of course, that's one of our biggest passions. So it makes sense. Talking a lot about vinyl. But I thought it would be cool to transition a little bit and talk about art. And that's a big general term, but to talk about painting, fine arts in general, because my good friend, you are a painter.
Mm.
And it amazes me how many clients we have, how many people we meet, we travel around, and they don't know you're a painter.
Yeah.
You know? And you're a great painter.
It's one of those things I don't really talk about it. I don't bring it up. I don't know what that is. You know, it's like you put on that hat. It's got to be someone that like plays music and they put that, they got to wear that hat,
right.
You know, or however that is. But yeah, I mean, I did stuff for, I've got multiple galleries and in Tampa and Orlando and Atlanta, in Savannah, did all the paintings in the JW Marriott and got a coffee table book coming out. And yeah, I've always been, that's just like the hobby. And
as long as I've known, I mean, we've known each other since we were kids.
Yeah.
You've always had a sketch pad, you know, something that you were creating, but let's at least let people know, like, how did you get into the fine arts painting piece of your creativity? How did that come about?
I think, you know, it's just always like you said, I'm always drawing and painting and sketching and those little things. And then finally I applied to Ringling College of Art and Design in Sarasota. And I thought that would be, what a phenomenal school, number one.
Yeah.
But I went there for, I wanted to go for graphic design because I liked the design aspect of it. And then when I was there my first year, I started doing these little competitions, painting and sculpture and stuff. And then I had all the professors coming like, you need to switch over to fine art. But I'm like, wow. I mean, come on, a degree in fine art.
Yeah.
Like,
what are you going to do with that?
Like, yeah, hell no. So I eventually did. And then I was like, but I have to go to grad school. And that whole business mindset, trying to think in the future and making sure I can fall back on something. But no, I just got into it and just kept painting. And then when I came out, I had a show in New York, and I had a show in Ohio and all around. But I've always had like a show I was working.
Yes, on. I remember the show in Ohio in particular, because that was one of my favorite. What year was that?
2000.
Wow.
2001.
Holy moly. 2000. Yeah. Man. But maybe we should talk a little bit about your internship in New York, because I think that's really, really cool.
Yeah.
So can you just like
shed a little light on that? Yeah, so it was my senior year, and it was really cool because Ringling had this phenomenal program, which it was through Parsons, and they chose one student out of like every state. And so in Florida, and I got selected for that, and they shipped me up to New York, and
that was an honor,
huge studio. Yeah. And all I had to do was paint, and I had a couple little really no classes. It was more critiques and stuff you would sit in. They had visiting artists and writers and journalists from like Art Forum and Art Magazine that would come in. And well, when I was there, and so now I've got this killer studio, I've got this great roommate and good friend of mine opened up her door and said, you can live here. And she lived in New York. And I had this studio, and all I did was paint every single day. But there was an artist that had visited Ringling, and I saw him do a lecture, and I was just like, this guy is the shit, you know? So found him in New York in his studio, and I wanted to work for him with him. I wanted to, you know, be around what he did. He was at Columbia. He was a graduate. He ran the graduate program at Columbia for fine art. Wow. He was an American landscape painter, Gregory Aminoff. And I walked in, I met him, and he hired me. And the very first day, did I ever tell you this, what he made me do the first day?
I don't know, but I'm thinking it's interesting.
Yeah. So I showed up, and he had a stack of Bob Dylan records, and he made me listen to every single one of them.
No way.
For 2 days straight, I had to sit.
That was your job?
I had to sit there for the first 2 days and just listen to Dylan albums from all the way through. And then he painted and all that stuff. And then we talk about the album when.
How cool.
Yeah. And then he's like, okay, I think you're ready.
I want that job.
So, because he was so influenced by Dylan.
Okay.
And, but phenomenal painter. He's still painting. He's still around. He's still doing his thing. But he gave me a phenomenal perspective on just how to approach art and don't listen to what people are saying. And everyone thinks that they're a massive critic, and, you know, you've got talent and just go with it. If you didn't have talent, you wouldn't be here, you know? But I've always got stuff I'm working on. I always have stuff that I'm doing.
Yeah.
I think the gallery's always like, we need more. We need more. Because I'll bring pieces and they'll sell. And then, you know, Shane, you should just stop what you're doing and just paint full time. And I said, I got interviewed out of Dayton, because I know we're going to be talking about Dayton here pretty soon. But I had the Dayton Daily News interview me like, out of college, and it was like a big deal. And I had this, they took me to the art museum, and they did photos, and they did all the stuff, because I had a big show. And going through and being interviewed by a newspaper, I said, well, you know, I got a better chance of being a shortstop for the Cincinnati Reds than I do a professional artist. And she goes, ooh. And I went, you're going to quote me on that, aren't you? And we opened up the paper in big black letters. What it said.
That's a great quote.
Yeah.
I love it. Man. Cool, man.
Yeah.
Well, keep up the good work.
Yeah, man. Cheers. Thanks for making me uncomfortable and talking about art. But
hey, listen, it's all